Have you ever dared to peek behind the veil of human history? Wondered what bizarre and potentially deadly rituals people have performed in the name of faith, power, or sheer desperation? We'll be uncovering the top 10 most dangerous rituals ever practiced. Buckle up and subscribe to our channel, because we're in for some chills, spills, and maybe even a glimpse of the supernatural. If we survive. Warning. The following video contains depictions of dangerous rituals that should not be attempted under any circumstances. The activities discussed in this video are extremely hazardous and can result in serious injury or even death. Under no circumstances should you attempt to replicate or participate in these rituals. 1. Human sacrifice. Human sacrifice, the ritualistic killing of a person, has been practiced across various cultures and throughout history. It was believed to appease or influence deities, bring about rain or victory in war, or ensure the continued well-being of a community. The Aztecs, for instance, were notorious for their frequent human sacrifices, believing it was necessary to keep the sun god moving across the sky. The practice of human sacrifice has largely disappeared today, due to its barbaric nature and the rise of moral and ethical codes. However, some isolated instances may still occur in remote areas or fringe religious groups. Beyond appeasing deities, human sacrifice could also be seen as a way to influence the natural world or communicate with the afterlife. Some cultures sacrificed individuals in times of crisis, such as famine or illness, hoping to appease the spirits responsible or send messages to deceased ancestors. Additionally, sacrificing a person of high status, like a king or warrior, might be seen as a way to transfer their power or wisdom to the recipient in the afterlife. 2. Self-harm rituals. Self-harm rituals are distinct from self-harm caused by mental health struggles. While they can be a sign of underlying issues, they are often performed with a specific purpose in religious or cultural contexts. These rituals can involve pain or bodily alteration, but are believed to hold a deeper meaning or bring about a desired outcome. For example, some cultures practice rituals involving bloodletting or whipping as a form of penance or sacrifice. In other traditions, self-harm rituals might symbolize a rite of passage, mourning, or heightened devotion. It's important to note that these acts are not undertaken lightly and are usually performed under the guidance of a religious leader or within a specific community. 3. Dangerous fire rituals. Dangerous fire rituals involve pushing the boundaries of heat tolerance and often lack proper safety measures. One well-known example is fire walking, where participants attempt to cross a bed of hot coals. While some believe fire walking brings spiritual benefits or tests courage, there's a high risk of burns. Similarly, rituals involving jumping over flames can lead to fire catching on clothes or accidental falls. The danger is heightened when these rituals are unsupervised or involve substances that can be flammable. Furthermore, some fire rituals are performed in enclosed spaces, which can lead to smoke inhalation and oxygen depletion. It's important to prioritize safety and avoid these practices unless under the guidance of experienced professionals with proper precautions in place. 4. Voodoo death. Voodoo death, also known as psychogenic death, isn't caused by malicious curses or magic. It's a psychosomatic phenomenon. Someone who believes they've been cursed by a powerful force experiences intense fear and despair. This extreme emotional state can have a dramatic impact on their body. Their heart rate and breathing may become erratic, blood pressure could drop, and they might even lose consciousness. In rare cases, this psychological response can be fatal. It's important to note that voodoo death isn't exclusive to voodoo itself. It can occur in any culture where someone believes they've been cursed or condemned to death. Modern science can explain it through the mind-body connection, where intense emotions trigger physiological changes that can be life-threatening. 5. Ritualistic fasting. Ritualistic fasting goes beyond simple calorie restriction. It's a practice observed in many religions and cultures for spiritual growth or connection to a higher power. Fasting periods can vary, but some rituals involve abstaining from all food and drink for extended durations. While done with good intentions, these extended fasts can be dangerous. The body needs a constant supply of nutrients and fluids to function properly. Dehydration, electrolyte imbalance, and even muscle breakdown can occur during prolonged fasting. Additionally, those with underlying health conditions or on medication may experience worsened symptoms. It's crucial to approach ritualistic fasting with caution, ensuring proper guidance and potential medical supervision, especially for extended periods. 6. Dangerous trance inductions. Trance states themselves aren't inherently dangerous, but some trance induction methods can be risky, especially when not performed by a trained professional. Certain rituals utilize intense techniques like rapid drumming, repetitive chanting, or even hyperventilation to induce trances. These methods can overwhelm the senses, leading to dizziness, disorientation, or even fainting. The real danger comes when someone in a trance state is vulnerable to suggestion. Without proper safeguards, a manipulative individual could exploit the heightened suggestibility to implant false memories, steal information, or even coerce actions. This is why it's crucial to participate in trance inductions only with experienced practitioners who prioritize safety and participant well-being. 7. Isolation rituals. Isolation rituals involve periods of solitary confinement or sensory deprivation, often undertaken for spiritual or personal growth. While some solitude can be beneficial, these rituals can be dangerous if taken to extremes. Prolonged isolation can disrupt our sleep cycles, lead to hallucinations and distortions in perception, and even trigger feelings of anxiety or paranoia. The human brain craves social interaction and stimulation. When deprived of these for extended periods, it can struggle to function normally. It's important for isolation rituals to have a clear purpose and well-defined time frame. Participants should also have a way to connect with someone outside the isolation if needed. Isolation rituals remain a compelling and complex facet of human behavior. 8. Rites of passage involving physical. Rites of passage involving physical are traditions in many cultures that mark a person's transition from one stage of life to another. These serve as a symbol of overcoming challenges and entering a new social status. The nature of these tests varies greatly depending on the culture. For example, some cultures might have coming-of-age rituals involving endurance tests, like running long distances or going without sleep for days. Others might involve dangerous hunting practices where young men must prove their courage and skill by tracking and killing a formidable animal. 9. Ritual drug use. Ritual drug use has been practiced for centuries across various cultures and for different purposes. Some cultures use psychoactive substances to connect with the spiritual realm, enhance healing ceremonies, or foster group bonding. Plants like peyote in Native American traditions or ayahuasca in South American rituals are examples. However, ritual drug use can be dangerous. The effects of these substances can be unpredictable, leading to intense hallucinations, disorientation, or even physical harm. Additionally, some rituals involve high doses or dangerous combinations, increasing the risk of adverse reactions. It's crucial for these practices to be conducted under the guidance of experienced individuals who understand the potential dangers and can ensure participant safety. 10. Talking to a stranger on the internet. While not a traditional ritual, talking to strangers online can have its own set of dangers. The anonymity of the internet can embolden some people to act in ways they wouldn't offline. Sharing personal information or meeting up with someone you only know virtually can put you at risk of scams, harassment, or even violence. However, the internet can also be a fantastic tool for connecting with people who share your interests or live far away. By following safety precautions like keeping conversations online for a while, avoiding sharing personal details, and being wary of meeting up in person, you can minimize the risks and enjoy the potential benefits of talking to strangers online. However, the very anonymity that allows for exploration can also breed a sense of detachment from real-world consequences. People may feel emboldened to act in ways they wouldn't dare to offline, leading to cyberbullying, harassment, or even online predation. Remember, your safety is paramount. Stay informed, stay vigilant, and always think twice before engaging in any potentially dangerous activities. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell so you never miss an episode. Did those rituals leave you speechless, or perhaps a little more informed about the darker side of humanity? Let me know in the comments below.